until Nazneen finishes her talk. Nazneen is going to summarize the entire session. See, most of the talks that we have covered today, basically, you know, you can have an entire instruction course on each topic. So we have compressed it to 85 minutes. So there are certain limitations, and I wish we have some time for discussion. What happened, Nazneen? Uploading it at the earliest possible opportunity. So all sessions that have been presented here will be available on the website. I mean, this has been going on for the last couple of years, so we are following the same trend this year too.
Faking, pseudophagic, post refractive, and a host of other conditions. So, coming to toric IOL calculations, monofocal toric IOLs provide a superior visual acuity. So, the anterior corneal measurements can be done by keratometry or tomography. As for the posterior corneal astigmatism, can be measured either by a direct measurement by like Galilei or Sheen femtotopographer, or via the Barrett toric calculator, or others like the Fizeal toric calculator. Barrett toric calculator was devised by Graham Bell. It is very accurate and it is available at ACRS and APACRS websites. The Kane toric formula also is said to give results as good as the Barrett toric calculator. The Fizeal calculator incorporates the Abulafia-Cobb formula and can be used with any other standard toric calculator. So intraoperative biometry, those who have it, it measures the eyes astigmatism in the aphakic state in the intraoperative phase. If you land up with a residual astigmatism, then how to tackle it, whether to rotate the IOL, whether to exchange it or to go for a refractive surgery, you can go to the astigmatism fix site and that will tell you how to tackle the situation. We have the Barrett RX formula. So the take-home messages are toric IOLs are the standard of care for astigmatism. Aim for multiple readings, use multiple instruments. Posterior corneal astigmatism is of course an important consideration. Ensure that the corneal astigmatism is regular. Use a good marking device. use advanced toric calculators, and do not forget, last but not the least, the surgeon-induced astigmatism, that you can use the Warren Hill Excel sheet, and you can calculate your own surgically induced astigmatism. Coming to secondary IOLs, they have a host of indications, like IOL exchange can be required for a wrong IOL power, for a subluxated IOL, for an opacified IOL, and for other situations. So of course we know that the implantation of IOL in the bag is the best, and the next is the sulcus implantation. In the bag and scleral fixated, we can use the usual calculators for sulcus implant and iris fixators. Calculate for the bag and adjust the power accordingly as given in the Warren Hill site. So these are few nomograms that you can use. For an anterior chamber IOL, you can roughly reduce the power by 2 diopters, and for these are some other nomograms that are available. For piggyback IOLs, calculate the total power needed for emmetropia and divide the power into bag and sulcus. You can also use this holiday IOL consultant, which is available at hicksoap.com, which uses 7 parameters like the axial length, K reading, white to white, the lens thickness, and other factors. If you don't have it, then it's not a problem. This is a rough guide. If you have a myopic error, multiply it by 1.2, and if you have a hyperopic error, multiply by 1.5, and that would be the IOL power required in a case of a secondary piggyback IOL. You can use certain other nomograms like the Gills nomogram, but the Barrett IOL formula is
Hausla ne bhar liya hai, faisla ye kar liya hai.
Great, are at risk of greater risk of
sabko bachayenge khud se ye vaada kar liya hai
india post operative hyperopia
jab zor lagayega tv harega desh jeetega india jab zor lagayega tv harega desh jeetega
or you can use the Barrett universal 2 along with your optical biometry, or you can use the Hill RBF formula. The latest one is also the LADA's super formula, which uses artificial intelligence. So Barrett's Universal 2 is one of the most accurate, and there is no need for adjusting the axial length. It is available, and the Hill RBF method is based on the artificial intelligence. The Hill RBF calculator is available, and it caters to extreme high myopia. And it provides calculations for IOLs from +5 to -5. The LADA super formula uses artificial intelligence and crowdsourcing, which means that we can use thousands and even millions of data points to achieve unprecedented accuracy in our IOL power calculations. Posterior staphyloma is a challenging situation. It must be recognized preoperatively using an ultrasound, and optical biometry is a better option for short eyes. There are a multitude of problems, like patient could be non-ophthalmic, there could be a shallow anterior chamber with a thick IOL, and you have a confusion as to which IOL power to choose. So optical biometry is a good choice, and few other options have already been discussed. Posterior segment situations are again challenging situations. Vitrectomized eyes, they have fragile capsule, weak zonules, and silicone oil filled eyes have been discussed by ma'am. They have silicone oil eyes, they can cause change in the refractive state or status of the eye, and can lead to errors in the axial length measurement. So there are several options, like do the biometry before the silicone oil insertion, or do it after the removal of the silicone oil, or do it in the other eye. These are few of the options. Optical biometry, of course, is the technique of choice for measuring the axial length, and you can use the formula like Barrett Universal 2 or the Imagetropia Verifying IOL, EVU IOL, or the Kane or the LADA Super Formula. For post-vitrectomy eyes, the IOL power formula which provide good results are Barrett Universal 2, the EVU IOL, the Kane IOL, and the LADA Super Formula. For post-refractive surgery cases, biometry after refractive surgery is challenging, and standard IOL power calculations can result in post-operative refractive surprise. Standard keratometry does not apply. It is difficult to calculate the effective lens position, and the traditional formulae do not work. So do a corneal topography, a Schimpflug topography, measure the anterior and the posterior corneal surface, and Holiday 2 is one good option. It is available at hicksoap.com. So this is the Isle Power formulae at a glance. To sum up, thorough history and a good examination, good patient counseling, opt for optical biometry where possible, take multiple readings and appropriate Isle Power calculation formula.